Namaskar. My name is Amir Modak. I consider this as an honor for me to present over here. And so I would really like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity. Today, I would like to discuss on a subject named Rohini Shakad Bhed, an ancient observed phenomenon. It's well known that the ancient Sanskrit texts on astronomy have recorded some of the observations with very high accuracy and precision. Not only that, they have also preserved these observations for long antiquity. These texts like Surya Siddhanta or Aryabhatiya describe some very fascinating phenomena. For example, presence of pole stars at both the poles, names of weekdays, and so on. One of such interesting phenomena is called Rohini Shakad Bhed. So we find a mention of this in Surya Siddhanta. It says, in the Vrishabh Rashi or the Taurus constellation, if at the 17th degree, if a planet attains southern latitude more than 2 degrees, then it will break the Shakad or cart of Rohini. We can see it pictorically. So here you see the Rohini Nakshatra in Taurus. The Rohini star is the one that is in reddish color. There are two more stars, Epsilon Tauri at the northern side and Gamma Tauri on the right hand side below. These three stars seem to form a triangular shape. This is called the Shakad or the cart of Rohini. Also, you see this yellow line above, that's the ecliptic. We see this cart of Rohini is seen below 2 degrees south of the ecliptic. So according to the Surya Siddhanta, if any planet comes in between this Epsilon Tauri and the Rohini star, which is also called as Alpha Tauri or Aldebaran in the Western terminology, then it would break the cart, or we can say that it would break through or pass through the cart of Rohini. Now going further, we also find mention of this in Bruhat Samhita of Varahamihira. He says that if this Rohini Shakad is broken by Saturn or Mars, that would actually create great disasters. We have the Graha Laghava also saying the same things. And in addition, it says, Bhaumyarkyo Shakat Bhida Yugantaresya. So, which means looking at the Mars and Saturn's current positions, position and coordinates, the Shakad Bhed by them had happened or must have happened long back in the past, and it doesn't seem to occur in the current times. So basically this would now raise certain questions, or rather very specific questions. So is there a way to determine which definition describes the phenomenon more accurately? Next one would be, are the Mars events objectively and independently testable? Any additional instances that can be found? Next one is the important one. Are there any Saturn instances? And finally, or if possible, when was the last time Shakad Bhed instance by either of the planet seen? So in order to find a solution for the problem stated, and obviously in turn to get the answers of the questions that were raised, I would make use of the scientific methodology, that is forming a postulate or a theory, calculating the consequences of it, and then comparing the consequences with the real world instances to validate the theory that has been proposed. Or we can say, in other words, going by the sutra by Patanjali, Pratyaksha Anumana Agama Pramanani. So here the theory would be quite straightforward. The Rohini Shakad Bhed by Saturn and Mars is a factual and visual observation of the sky made in the past. That would be our theory. And now we would want to objectively test whether there were any Shaktibheda events by Mars and Saturn in the past, basically to validate this. So for that, I used latest astronomy simulation software named Voyager version 4.5. Basically, I need to run the simulations of the sky for checking the events that are mentioned over here. So actually, for doing the testing using the Voyager, actually I found it's a bit easier to verify independently the Mars Shaktibheda events claimed by Wahi et al. Because the dates are already present. The dates are already available. Here are the dates given by Wahi et al. For Mars doing the Shaktibheda. And actually, I was able to verify three out of them, three out of these four instances. And these are the instances given by me. We see here there is a difference of 2 years for each of these years given by Wahi et al. Between their years and my years. So there is a consistent difference of 2 years over here. This would be an interesting subject of study to find what would be the cause of this particular difference of 2 years. This would be a separate subject, I think, and I would not go into that right now as it may create a digression from the current subject. So obviously going forward, I wanted to check when I was doing the testing the additional instances of Mars, if there are any. So I ran the simulation starting from 13,000 BCE till date. So I used a period of 15,000 years. And here are the results. I actually found, I've listed a few of the Mars, additional Mars instances over here. But actually I have found more than 80 instances in this 15,000 years period. Please take a look at the last instance. This is actually the last instance of Shaktibheda by Mars, that is on 4355 BC. So it is the last instance by Mars was somewhere around 6,000 years old. Obviously, next thing would be doing the checking the Saturn instances, that is checking whether Saturn does Shaktibheda or not. So I again ran the simulations starting from 13,000 BCE till date, the same 15,000 year period. And it was amazing to see there were two instances I can find of Saturn doing the Shaktibheda, and here they are. So actually I am the first one to show the Saturn Shaktibheda instance. I would like to mention here that limiting myself at 13,000 BC was just for the sake of stopping somewhere after getting sufficient data to assert my point. While doing this validation and testing, I found that searching for these instances becomes really a tedious task for anyone, or rather at least for me. So I just put this limit on myself. Obviously, I had got sufficient data to assert my point, and this actually should not be restrictive, and I would have definitely gone more into the past if I had not found any instances in this interval. So now basically we'll revisit the research work. Sri S.B. Dixit claimed both the planets must have done Shaktibheda before, and that is now validated by me. And then I have also corrected the lower boundary to 4355 BC for any of the planet or either of those planets to do the Shaktibheda. For Wahi et al, I have independently verified three out of four Mars instances with a consistent difference of 2 years. They claimed that there is no Saturn instance of Rohini Shaktibheda but I have falsified that and I have shown two instances of Saturn doing the Shackled Bay. Now, since basically the Saturn and Mars instances are shown, it actually strongly supports the definition that planet breaking or passing or piercing through the Shackled or entering the Rohini Shackled definition. It actually strongly supports that. And we can see that this particular definition more accurately defines or describes the Rohini Shackled Bay phenomenon than the definition that a planet gets close to the Epsilon Tauri or the Shackled of Rohini. Also, if we see the meaning of the word used, Bhed, or the Mool, the root word Bhed, which means to break, split, which also supports this particular definition. Coming to the Saturn claims by K. Chandrahari, he hasn't shown Saturn entering or breaking through or passing through the Shackled in his time period 1000 BC to 600 CE. So the Saturn claims by him get falsified. For Mars claim, obviously Wahia et al. Have already falsified his claim, which I have verified independently too. There is one more interesting thing that I want to mention over here. Sri K. Chandrahari mentions that Mars doesn't do the Shackled Bay because it never attains southern latitude more than 2 degrees in his period. I actually wanted to check this, and when I checked this, I actually found there are at least 5 instances where Mars goes beyond 2 degrees in southern latitude, and at the time being very close to the Epsilon Tauri star, which means Sri K. Chandrahari's, using K. Chandrahari's definition itself, we have falsified his Mars claims. So thus, basically, our postulate gets validated that the Rohini Shackled Bay by Mars and Saturn are actual and factual and visual observation of the sky made at made in the past. It gets validated. Of course, it gets validated tentatively, until there comes a better theory that would explain the phenomenon with even better objective evidences and better objective testing and verification. This is just like any other scientific theory that is tentatively valid till any better explanation with better evidences come up. So now we can list down the conclusions. Rohini Shackled Bay by Saturn shown for first time by me. Then the Mars instances that were earlier shown are independently and objectively tested and verified. Additional instances shown. The theory of Rohini Shackled Bay by Mars and Saturn being a visual observation, factual observation of sky, thus gets validated as mentioned. Then Dikshit's claim stand, lower boundary also corrected. Saturn claim for Wahia et al. Gets falsified, while 3 of the 4 Mars claims gets validated. Sri K. Chandrahari's Saturn as well as Mars claims are falsified. So basically, finally, before ending, I would like to make an interesting, I would like to mention here that this Rohini Shackled Bay is an excellent example of the ancient wisdom that has come to us, that was propagated through the ages, through the, and also through the scriptures for a long time, for a millennia. Yeah, so before closing, I would just like to show the simulations of one of the Mars observation doing Rohini Shackled Bay, and then Saturn doing the Shackled Bay. So this is for the Mars doing the Shackled Bay. Please watch carefully. And this is Saturn doing the Chakravarti. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for giving me this opportunity.